know you have her. Please, we just want Mayrina back.
Lads, for the love of all that is holy, I've never clapped eyes on your poor sister.
Drop the act, hag. You was the last to see Mayrina.
Just let her go. Please.
Thank goodness you're here, sweetie. I don't know what's come over these boys.
Stop this! We won't ask again!
Careful! Don't trust a word out of her mouth. Our sister went to the hag, and we ain't seen her since.
Hand over heart, I don't know their sister. I will gladly help you all look for her, though.
Enough. Where is she?
Sweetie, be careful!
She's with the hag!
Don't bloody stand there gaping! Get her!
Let's play.
Oh, my stars! I didn't mean for this to happen. She's their little sister, and she's staying with me. This is all my fault. But I made a promise. Mayrina begged me not to breathe a word if they came looking for her. And my word is my bond. That poor thing will be distraught. We can't let her know it and break her poor heart. I'd best get going, but please stop by my house. I'd like to thank you proper.
A classic routine. I'm kicking myself for not seeing through it.
Chill runs up your spine. You feel like you're being watched. You blink and the wilderness changes. The swamp, stinking and insidious, assaults your senses.
everywhere. Something made a mess of this place.
I wonder what kind of creature could have caused so much damage.
Won't work. I won't give in.
Thank you.
Again.
Might will prevail. What fools these mortals be.
Try something else. But to keep going.
much for peace.
Well met.
Might be worth a look.
That might be worth a look.
Oh, lovely little peg be up.
Murderous glare of a red cap, a fey creature known for its bloodlust, greets you. That noise. Is the creature pretending to be a sheep?
Again, this creature doesn't realize you can see its true form.
Curious.
Green leaves! Shallow water! Green leaves! Shallow water!
Up your spine. There is something wrong with this creature. Very wrong.
Green leaves, shallow water. Green leaves, shallow water.
Ah, stranger. Forgive the aroma.
You catch a waft of something foul, metallic, and sickly sweet.
Powdered iron vine. An old hunter's trick. Most monsters will think twice before making a meal of me.
You're a monster hunter? I'm surprised. I thought all Ger were vagrant cutthroats.
And more. We steal chickens, curse your crops, seduce your daughters, the list goes on. Now, I wish I had half the power settled folk think my people possess. Alas, I am a simple wanderer. A simple wanderer and monster hunter. But I'm no witch doctor or cutthroat.
Something terrifying, no doubt. Dragon? Cyclops? Kobold?
Nothing so dramatic. I'm hunting for a vampire spawn. His name is Astarion, but I fear he's gone to ground. I hope the hag of these lands can help me flush him out, if I can afford her blood price. Not this time. My orders are to capture him.
Oh. And bring him where, exactly?
Baldur's Gate. My people wait for me there.
I don't know. I'm sure a vampire spawn could still rip out your throat if he felt like it.
He is right, unfortunately. They are only weak when compared to their masters. During the day, we have the advantage, but at night, when they hunt, you'll not find a more deadly quarry.
We've all survived so far. Let's focus on that.
It would still be wise to post guards at night. The threat is real.
Indeed it is. We should do something about this threat. Wait, that's it. We're just walking away. Fine, but if this comes back to bite us, it's on your head.
Go in peace, my friends. I pray our paths cross again.
They better bloody not.
Fetid smell assaults your nostrils. Dead flesh lies below. A great deal of it.
I don't want a crumb left on that plate, girl.
Auntie Ethel, please. One more bite and this pie is gonna come back up to say hello.
Don't make me get the wooden spoon. You're eating for two, so get to it. Oh, if it isn't my hero. You took ages. Come in, come in. Feel free to relax yourself and have a cuppa, hmm? Gods, grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. I won't say it again. Beautiful, isn't it? It's my little refuge for the lost and hopeless. People in dire need travel from all over Faerûn to see little old me. And I do my damnedest to help them. And you, Petal, well, you need a lot of help. That wriggler swimming in your brain juice is a bit of an inconvenience, isn't it? Because you stink. And I know the stench of Mind Flayer anywhere. I can tell you're almost done cooking. You know, you could turn just like that. What do you say? Want me to take care of the little bugger? Well, that depends on the job. Removing a parasite is no small feat. But I like you, Petal. So I'll only ask for something small. One of your pretty little peepers. I pluck it from your head, kiss it for luck, then back in it goes. Won't take but a moment. That is my price. Nothing more, nothing less. I'm afraid that's my business, Petal. It's nothing nefarious, though. I promise.
Ethel, can I please?
Quiet, you've had enough pampering. And you, my door is always open, Petal. Auntie Ethel is here for you.
Not for communal use, it seems. Best show some respect. Or some more cunning.
Just out of view.
Sweetness, you're going to give me one of those precious peepers. Ta-ta, Petal. Come see Auntie soon.
ones reported a theft in this area. It seems you're the likely culprit. What will you do? You've been given the benefit of the doubt this time, but something tells you next time you won't be so lucky.
No.
Awake and alert.
That's no fire. What are you hiding?
sweetness. You going to give me one of those precious peepers? Ta-ta, Petal. Come see Auntie soon.
Let's turn someone inside out. Let's find some prey.
On the victor's path. Swords meet sorcery. My condition likes being ignored as little as I do. I must consume another artifact. And soon. Perhaps I'm not conveying the urgency of the situation. It's incredibly, world-shatteringly important you give me a suitable artifact. Please. Thank you. Has any effect. Oh, Mistra, have mercy on us all. Listen, I need to speak to you, to all of you. It would be unconscionable of me to remain silent. The waste it might have been. You have to know who I was. You have to know who I really am. What I am is a walking shadow of the promise I once held. I'm what one might call a wizard prodigy, who from an early age could not only control the weave, but compose it, much like a musician or a poet. Such was my skill that it earned me the attention of the Mother of Magic herself. The Lady of Mysteries. The Goddess Mystra. She revealed herself to me and she became my teacher. In time, she became my muse. And later, even my lover. I am, after all, the villain of the tale. We enjoyed each other's company. Body, mind, and soul. But even so, I desired more. You see, no matter how powerful a wizard we mortals can become, we never scratch more than the surface of the weave. Mystra keeps us in check. There are boundaries she doesn't let us cross. Yet, every time I was with her, I stood on the precipice, gazing into the wonders that lay beyond. I sought to cross her boundaries. I tried to convince her. I pouted. I pleaded. Swore my ambition was only to serve her better. She only smiled and told me to be contented. Inconceivable as it seems to me now, I shared a bed with a goddess, and yet I wasn't satisfied. So I sought to prove myself worthy to her instead. We come now to the crux of my folly. Shall I share the story behind it, or would you rather head straight to its sordid finale? Very well. Here goes. Once upon a very long time ago, a mighty lord lived in a tower. A flying tower, to be precise. I'll save his history for another time, but the gist of it is that he sought to usurp the goddess of magic so that he could become a god himself. And he almost managed, but not quite. And his entire empire, Netheril, came crashing down around him as he turned to stone. The magic that was unleashed that day was phenomenal. Roiling like the prime chaos that outdates creation. Even the weave itself could not withstand the onslaught. It fractured, then shattered, and all magic was lost to the mortal realms. Until the day Mystra returned. She restored the weave, reuniting all its scattered shards. Or so I thought. Until, in the course of my studies, I learned of a book. Netherese tome in which a piece of the fractured weave had been sealed beyond her reach. What if, I thought, what if, after all this time, I could return this lost part of herself to the goddess? The answer was to try. And the outcome was to fail. I was certain that this deed of raw power, draped in romance, would convince Mystra to take me by the hand and welcome me into her hitherto forbidden domains. I was mistaken. I obtained the fabled book and took it into my study. As for what happened next...
Here. Place your hand over my heart. Let me show you.
You feel the tadpole quiver as you realize Gale is letting you in, into the dark. You see through Gale's eyes, staring down the corridors of a dread memory. A book bound and suddenly opened. Inside there are no pages. Only a swirling mass of blackest weave that pounces. Its teeth, its claws, it's unstoppable as it digs through and becomes part of you. And gods, is it ever hungry.
What is it? What do you see?
Thank you.
Terrifying, isn't it? And that is only the beginning. This Netherese blight, this orb, for lack of a better word, is balled up inside my chest. And it needs to be fed.
As long as I absorb traces of the weave from potent enough sources, remains quiet. Were it ever to fully destabilize, however.
I will erupt. I don't know the exact magnitude of the eruption, but given my studies of Netherese magic, I'd say even a fragment as small as the one I carry, it'd level a city the size of Waterdeep. Every waking moment. Every dreaming moment, too. But there was no way out. All of this. It must feel like a betrayal. Say the word, and we'll part ways. Once I'd step out of the protective aura of the artifact, it wouldn't be long before the Absolute overtakes me. I'd never let that happen, so I'd aim for a swift end. I would consume sub-midnight tears and venture as deep into the Underdark as I possibly could, till they cloud my eyes forever. With a bit of luck, I'd manage to make it to a Mind Flayer colony so that when the orb erupts, one loud, last song of vengeance would reverberate through the dark. Wouldn't be a heroic end, but coarsely poetic enough in its justice. That is a great relief. Oh, a great relief indeed. You truly are a soul that steals my own. From all my new rallied heart, I thank you. I thank you all. I understand if you stand against me. I'm humbled if you stand with me. Either way, I will do my best not to let you down. I stand at a precipice, but if you do not give up hope, neither shall I. I'll fight. I'll resist as long as I can. Now, even I am tired of the sound of my own voice. Let us venture forth.
You are as thick as they come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Get out! Has that wriggler eaten your brain already? Leave, or you'll end up in tonight's stew. You'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's already marinating.
Stop.
What's that?
Please!
My sweet Callum, whose beloved asked that his beauty never fade.
Don't look.
As you edge closer to the mirror, a pale face appears. Contorted in fear, fists slam against the mirror's surface again and again.
Wait! Wait! Don't.
What is this place?
Please.
This poor dear wished never to lay eyes on her family again.
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through, not again. Images flash. A man cowering, a bag open at his feet. Gold coins spilling onto the floor. His cries for mercy are cut short as the hag slices into him, dismembering him painstakingly, limb by limb. She cackles, the man's remaining flesh twisted and contorted, becoming the twisted surface of the door before you. Flee, you feel it cry. Frustrated, the door rattled. You see the hag and yourself. You lay bleeding as she leans over you, a smile on her face. Her teeth, a row of deadly needles, shine as they dive into your throat, blood spraying. The door twitches, but stays firm. You see the hag. She walks through the door, its form shimmering. The lightest touch of hope brushes your mind as the presence within retreats.
Away! Away! Don't.
My gentle Lauren.
Don't.
I wish to know what was to come. A thief who tried to steal from Auntie. Now the good little pet guards my home.
Away! Away! No. No! Don't look. Mustn't look, mustn't see. I see it. I see what's to come. Me. Dead. Dead! Flesh rotten, bone shining! No. Future. Bone splitting. Knife twisting. Skull screaming. Future! Gods, don't hurt me. Oh, please. Please. Please, please, please! Trick! They're the monster! Monster! The mind dripping! Flesh peeling! Mind flayer! No! No! Mind flayer! Get away! Get away!
No intention of letting that happen.
Don't look. Don't!
Still me. Even after everything. Still me, even after everything.
Stop! Please! Please!
your bag.
Be kind to our guests.
Enemies. favors the fearless.
Trap. Be cautious. believe this.
Don't touch me.
Oh. What to do?
I smell a trap.
There, in the cage.
You come to my home, interfere in my business, and now have the gall to face me in the heart of my lair! You petulant bollocks! I'll rip your spine out your asshole! I'll use your blood to spice my stew! I'll keep you alive until I've sucked the marrow from your bones! Then I'll bring you back and do it all over again.
Just get out of here, please.
You want the girl so bad. Fine.
That girl hasn't got long. If you plan to save her.
Time to push my luck again.
Striking distance. The blade will not bend.
dull moment. Mind if I do?
Fleet of foot. Over here.
Forever dauntless. No time to waste.
Thank you.
Don't linger.
Bloody clever clogs!
Thank the gods!
May the dice roll in my favor.
Favors the fearless.
Swift as my feet can carry me. Step forward.
Battle favors the fearless.
Yeah.
fancy their chances. Step by step. This is my time.
Worth the cost. Don't waste a step.
I've missed this. Now they see me. Time to move.
Creator, destroyer. Double.
Take this!
Nothing will stand in my way. What path lies before me? Can't even catch my breath.
Gentlemen. Step to it.
This is my time.
What now? Time for some bloody work.
Swiftly now. No holding back.
What a burst. Sunset can't come quickly enough.
How you go? There's a trap.
You bastard! You ruined it! You ruined everything! slap is all you deserve. Ethel was going to bring my husband back. Back from the dead. And now I'll never see him again. Because of you. This. Just a bit longer and my child would have been born. And all this would have been over. This was the best chance I had. For me and my baby. Auntie Ethel promised to give this child a good life. Teach them magic, even. More than I could have done. Said I'd make a bad mother. I think she was right. Now I'll have to drag Connor's coffin all the way home. It's the only way this child will ever meet their father. I hope you're happy.
That orb seems powerful. What can it do once it's extracted?
Nothing good can come of it unless it is contained. Why?
It might be useful. Who knows?
Gods! Didn't hear you coming. I know I should head home, but I can't bring myself to leave. The thought of putting him in a wheelbarrow and making the journey all over again. We were just kids when we met. I might have pushed him off a swing I wanted. He got right up and pushed me back. I was so surprised that I just laughed. He did too. We've barely spent a day apart since. Not even a little bit. But I will be. I'm sorry I couldn't bring you back.
What is it?
Let's get going. Tempers are rising. It's clear not everything you find is at your disposal.
You're a miserable bastard, you know that?
I'm sorry I couldn't bring you back.
Here lies Connor, beloved husband, and a tasty little morsel to boot.
I admire your courage, Gale.
Thank you. Any particular reason?
Between the orb and the bug, you've got more than your fair share of unwelcome passengers.
What can I say? Mother always taught me to be a gracious host.
Gales had this devastating orb within himself the entire time, and only just mentioned it.
Who'd keep a secret like that from his friends? You can't trust anyone these days.
What? You can.
You feel a surge of power from the wand. The air suddenly tastes acrid. It wants to be used.
Bring it back. Bring Connor back. Please. Is gone! Happy! 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 Come! Present!
Still on my feet.
survival is all that matters.
Rill.
Victor's path.
Nothing important is ever easy.
battle favors the fearless. Making my move. The witching hour. On my way.
Delicious. Time for a new approach. Victory is assured.
Victor's path.
Some healing for a wizard in need.
Gods are watching me.
On the victor's path. Let my enemies fall. No gloom.
Let's have some courage.
Tell you go. There's a trap.
soldier.
Make room then, and hurry.
I promised I'd be back. Don't worry. I have things under control. For now. You haven't been using the parasite's power. You think you don't need it. But things haven't gone as you expected. You hoped a druid as powerful as Halsin might be able to remove your tadpole. But he couldn't. You're desperate to be rid of it. Understandable. But you're looking for solutions in the wrong places. It's complicated, but I'm an adventurer, just like you. Just like you, I was infected with a mind flayer parasite. Just like you, I seek to be free of it. But to do that, we'll need to think beyond local healers. Your parasite is unusual. It is wrapped in magic that prevents its removal. Until the source of the tadpole's magic is destroyed, any attempt to remove it will kill you. You were lucky that Halsin knew this. His instincts are right. The parasites are merely a symptom of a greater sickness in Faerun. I have kept a careful watch on the movements of the cult. Though the Absolute's aims are not yet clear to me, its methods are. These parasites are more than illithid spawn. They are vessels for control. The infected hear the voice of the Absolute and believe it to be a god. You witnessed it yourself with Priestess Gut. That is how the cult of the Absolute is spreading. The highest of their rank, the True Souls, carry a tadpole just like yours. It is how they receive their orders. It is what makes them obey. When the order to transform is given, it will not be a matter of days. They will be mind flayers in an instant. Were it not for my protection, so would you. Because we share a common cause and a common enemy. We are alike, you and I. I've been trying to escape from this evil for a long time. Once, I almost succeeded. Now, through you, I've been given a new chance. You can go where I cannot, and I can protect you from that evil. If we work together, we may turn this around. Hells, they need me. I have to go. The power I used to protect you, I stole it from someone. They want it back. I will hold them off for as long as I can, but sooner or later I will be worn down. You must discover the source of the magic that controls the parasites before that happens. The cultists are gathering at Moonrise Towers.
Use the powers your parasite gives you to convince them you are one of them. And when you find the source of their magic, destroy it. Go. Our freedom depends on it.
Dog pants through a ball held firmly in his mouth. He relinquishes the ball. It is well chewed and slick with drool. His eyes track the ball avidly. He shuffles on his paws, ready to chase after it. Scratch's tongue lolls out happily, his tail wagging even faster.
I had another dream last night. The visitor came to me and ordered me to penetrate the heart of the very cult that's spreading the infection. It gave me a tadpole gift too, just like it did the first time it appeared. I suppose it hoped this would help. At first, I thought we should avoid these gifts no matter what advantage we gain. And yet, I can't help recall the words of my father. The best plan is the one that works. These powers could be enough to edge us towards victory. Then we'd do well to walk around it. Use these powers sparingly, if you must use them at all.
Dog pants through a ball held firmly in his mouth. He relinquishes the ball. It is well chewed and slick with drool.
I had another dream last night. The visitor came to me and ordered me to penetrate the heart of the very cult that's spreading the infection. It gave me a tadpole gift too, just like it did the first time it appeared. I suppose it hoped this would help. At first, I thought we should avoid these gifts no matter what advantage we gain. And yet, I can't help recall the words of my father. The best plan is the one that works. These powers could be enough to edge us towards victory. Then we'd do well to walk around it. Use these powers sparingly, if you must use them at all. Are you sure? The blade stands at the ready. And just when things were warming up.
I had another dream. Which, I suppose, means you did as well. Whoever's reaching out to us truly does seem opposed to the Absolute. Wants us to embrace the tadpole. Venture right into the heart of the cult. Perhaps we truly have a secret protector. Or we're walking into a trap.
All right, some company wouldn't hurt on the road. Especially if there's trouble. Still no symptoms.
No sign of tentacles so far.
The same. Except for a knot of worry in my stomach that's in no rush to go away.